Hey everyone, my name is Tim, and today I'll be talking about site tracking, event tracking, and Google Analytics. I'll explain their differences and how you can use them to gain insights into your customers. Data has always been a cornerstone in marketing, and understanding the importance is key to your success. Site tracking, event tracking, and Google Analytics are tools which help you learn more about how your customers interact with your business. Firstly, let's go through each of them and learn a little bit about them. Let's start with site tracking. So, what is site tracking with ActiveCampaign? Site tracking is a process of collecting data about how visitors interact with your website, such as pages customer visit, the frequency of their visits, and when they last visited. Site tracking allows you to create marketing and sales processes that leverage behavioral targeting, triggered messages, and granular segmentation. These have proven to improve the contact's experience and increase conversions. Now, let's jump into the platform and see how we set up site tracking. Firstly, we need to click on Website on the left-hand side of your account. It's an image of a web browser. Once this loads, we need to click on Site Tracking in the middle on the left-hand side. This will take us through to the setup page. Now that we're here, we first need to toggle Enable button under Site Tracking at the very top. Once you've done that, enter your website URL under the Whitelist Your Website section. Check to include all website pages and then click Add. Finally, copy the tracking code and paste it into the footer of your website. Note, if you're using WordPress, you can download the ActiveCampaign plugin and enable site tracking there. Your contacts will start being tracked when a cookie is added. This is done in ActiveCampaign when they complete an ActiveCampaign form or click a link in an ActiveCampaign campaign. You can also have the option to dynamically insert the email addresses of known visitors into tracking code, but this is for advanced users. When would I use site tracking? You can use site tracking to get a general overview of your contacts and the page visits they view on your site. You can then use that data to segment your contacts. Now, let's look at event tracking. Event tracking is a flexible feature that helps you collect data on various contact behavior. You can create an event for any activity on your website or app and assign it a value. As you begin to capture event data and send it to your ActiveCampaign account, you can then use that to improve your marketing and sales processes, as well as use it to trigger automations, create segment conditions, and personalize campaigns. Now, let's jump into the platform again to see how we set up event tracking. Firstly, we need to click on the website on the left-hand side of your account. As before, it's an image of the web browser. Once this loads, we just need to click Site Tracking on the left-hand side. This will take us through to the setup page. Scroll down to the bottom of the page and toggle on event tracking. Once this is turned on, you need to use programming language of your choice on your site to capture the following four data points. The who, the contact's email address. Performed, the event that is defined by you. The value, a value that is also defined by you, and the when, the time and date the event happened. Then you'll want to use ActiveCampaign's open API to send this event information. When this information is sent, ActiveCampaign will match the email address of your contact to the contact's email address in your ActiveCampaign account. So, when would you use event tracking? You would use it to understand how users engage with specific elements of your website or app, measure the effectiveness of calls to action or other interactive features, and track conversions and goals. Last but not least, Google Analytics. Google Analytics is a free analytics service offered by Google that tracks and reports website traffic. It allows website owners to see how visitors interact with their website, including audience demographics, age, gender, interest, location, acquisition, how visitors find your website, For example, search engine, social media, direct traffic. Behavior, what visitors do on your website. Example, what pages viewed, the time spent on space, and the rate. Conversions, whether the visitors complete desired actions, whether they purchase, they submit a form, or they sign up for a newsletter. In ActiveCampaign, you can turn on Google Analytics, which adds a UTM perimeter to all links in the emails. This allows you to track campaign clicks in your Google Analytics account. Let's jump into the account one final time to see how we set up Google Analytics. Firstly, we need to go to Settings on the bottom left-hand side of your screen. It's a small cog. Then, once this is loaded, we select Advanced from the left-hand side. And finally, scroll down to Google Analytics Tracking and set Google Analytics Tracking on for all campaigns. You can also set this on a campaign by campaign basis by checking the Google Analytics option under the Tracking and Automation section of the campaign. You need to make sure that site tracking is enabled for this feature to work. When would you use Google Analytics? You would use Google Analytics if you want to track your website traffic and user behavior to gain in-depth insights into your audience and how they interact with your site, and track conversions and measure the ROI of your marketing campaigns. Final thoughts. When choosing which one to implement, I would recommend asking yourself the following questions. Firstly, the purpose. What are you trying to track and measure? Secondly, budget. How much are you willing to spend on a tool? And finally, ease of use. How comfortable are you with setting up the technical setup and configuration? Well, that was a lot. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.
Check out these related videos and subscribe if you want updates on our channel. Thanks for watching.